Hello, I am Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. I am an educationist by profession and an astrologer by passion. Today, I am going to discuss with you about mundane astrology. So, what is mundane astrology? It is nothing but the study of how the changing planets, due to their constant movement, impact or affect the world events. Mundane astrology is called Medini astrology. Medini is a Sanskrit word for earth. So this word Medini includes the entire world. Now, based on the movement of planets, their direct and retrograde motion, combustions and their aspects, one can predict the major events like natural calamities, say for example famine or flood or tsunami. We can study about the economy, then the crops and rise and fall of commodities and wars and yearly predictions of a country and so on. It is interesting to note that in the earlier times, ancient times, all the kings had their own astrologer in the court, who were specialized in this branch of astrology and who used to provide guidance to kings when to attack somebody or when to withdraw the battle or, you know, how to go about the things, everything, anything and everything they used to predict. So in ancient texts like Brihat Samhita, then Bhavishya Phala Bhaskara and others, there are many astrological formulae or combinations. These are called as actually sutras to study and interpret such major events. Of the modern times, mundane astrology by Mr. K.N. Rao is a good one to study this branch. He gives a lot of illustrations in this book which help you to understand the principles and apply them in the situation. Now, a horoscope of a country is cast using the location of its capital, and there are some astrologers who don't even get into this. They go by the horoscope of a leader if that leader is very strong enough to carry that country forward. Because a country of whatever place or whatever country you're talking about. Why this is so? Because if he is a very powerful leader, then the future of a country depends, or it is in the hands of a leader in that interpretation. However, let us discuss about casting the horoscope of a country based on its genesis or origin. Say, for example, if we want to cast a natural chart of India. So what will be the date of birth for this? It is 15th August 1947. Time will be midnight, 2 minutes past 12 o'clock. And the place obviously will be Delhi, because we have to take the capital of a country as a place of birth. So actually, you can use any software online and cast this chart. There is a strong connection between the movement of the planets and their gravitational pull and that is exercised on the Earth, as a result of which events take place. Now, actually speaking, mundane astrology is actually a very, very vast subject. And people study it for years together and specialize in this branch. I'm not an expert, but I have fairly good knowledge because I go through a lot of texts and the ancient texts because of my good hold on Sanskrit. So I'm able to read and understand the stuff. So that is another blessing. So actually, how do we master any field of astrology? It is not just predicting the future by 2 plus 2 equal to 4 combination. It's not that way. You need to understand one sutra or one formulae what is given in these texts. You have to observe so many horoscopes. I have gone through thousands of horoscopes. On the internet also, you just search for a person's horoscope, but don't read what predictions they are giving. You go and, celebrities' horoscopes and national leaders and politicians, any horoscope you can get, you study their events and use your own, logic and your own learning. So that's how you're going to master the branch of astrology. And actually, I haven't seriously considered, becoming a specialist in I mean, Medini astrology, but those who want can definitely go. This, you know, I've been a student of astrology for 30 years now, but I'm still learning. I must say that it's a very, very vast field. It's very deep and very fascinating. The more and more you learn, the more and more you feel you are ignorant and you are drawn towards it. That is the, you know, depth of this subject, I would say. And it's my humble attempt again to share my knowledge with you and especially the students of astrology. If you liked my video, please subscribe to my channel. And, you know, you also may suggest the topics, what you want to know about in your comment section. And this is how actually, like, you know, there are so many videos uploaded on YouTube now about COVID-19. So if anybody has analyzed this, this is by using the principles of Medini astrology. So what is the future of India or how it is going to be? So thank you for watching. And I'll soon be uploading a video on understanding and analyzing this COVID-19 also. And to talk about India in brief, India, the horoscope India of India is a complete, characterized by Kala Sarpa Yoga. And Chandra Rashi for India is Karka. Okay. And in the Lagna itself, there are so many planets. So actually, Karka Rashi indicates very, you know, sentimental and emotional and all that. Emotionality is a trait of Indians. Like, we all are emotional people, right? And also, there are a lot of things happening in our country. Many yajnas and yagas and everything happen, and there are religious people and there are notorious people. So somehow the balance is maintained and we are able to survive in a better way. Anyway, I will speak in my other video more about India and its future, and I'll be uploading a video on COVID-19 also. Thank you for watching. God bless.